Yes, I'm finally back on the Dinette Table project. We had an unusual cold snap, and it was just too cold to continue working on this because I want to spray this up in the attic. That's right, I said spray, even though I had originally shown a can of polyurethane that I was going to brush on. I decided to spray after my experience with filling in the grain and then sealing it. Even with the best quality brush I had, the brush marks were still pretty noticeable, and I figured I'd have a similar issue with the polyurethane. Also, I popped open that can, and the fumes were stronger than I thought they'd be, and it's about 4 hours of dry time between coats, so I just don't really want to do that inside. Whereas the spray, exactly the same stuff, Minwax, fast-drying polyurethane, semi-gloss, this is more like 2 hours between spraying. This is also really intense, though. And minimum temperature, they say, is 50 degrees Fahrenheit. And it's just approaching that today, so I think that is good enough. Here it is after the first coat. I think it looks pretty nice. Spray cans are easy to work with. This has an adjustable nozzle, very similar to the old Deft lacquer that's no longer available. It's been a little over a week since I applied the poly to the tabletops, It's been about a week now since I applied the polyurethane to the tabletop. It's nice and set up. Smooth, hard. I think this will work out just fine. And as for the look, I like it. It's not perfect. Some of the sanding marks showed through more than I thought they would. The recommendation was to use 220, but maybe I'd go 320 in the future or apply it more heavily. Only issues I've got really are on this one where it was a more flawed surface. And in some of the areas like here where I applied the sanding sealer a bit thicker, it's a little cloudy. Now, that stuff goes on really milky, and in thin layers it does look completely transparent, but I guess if you build it up pretty thick, it does get a little milky. Only other option, two other options, was to leave a noticeable dip there or to plane down the whole surface to make it flush. As it is, I can live with that. And other issues on the edge here. Similar deal where the, you probably can't see that too well. In some areas, the sanding sealer was a little too thick on the sides. But again, that doesn't really bother me too much, so. I'm done with the tabletops, finally. What I want to move on to now is to finish up those support boards that go underneath. I've got to get my drill press out and do some experimenting. I have a 1-inch Fossner bit, and I picked up this 1 1/8 spade bit. I'm hoping the Fossner bit, however you pronounce that, will be large enough. When I measured the original holes, it seemed kind of like right in between, more like 1 1/16, but they just don't sell a drill bit of that size. So I'm going to try with the 1. Maybe need to do a little pounding to get the pegs in, or just to maybe sand or file it a little bit larger. Or if it's really just not going to work, I'll give this a try. I made a very nice, neat 1-inch hole with this Fossner bit. Now I'm going to give a try with the 1 1/8 inch spade bit. And then I'll do a test against the old legs and see which hole works better. Okay, there we go. Spade isn't quite as nice a hole, but certainly sufficient for my purposes. Now it's just a matter of which one works better. Here's one of the legs. Let's do a little test fit. One inch, definitely too small. Could spend some time reaming that out a little bit larger. Let's try the 1 1/8. I'd say that's pretty good fit. Little bit of play, but I figure once I shoot some glue in there, the wood's gonna swell up a bit. And it should work out just fine. So that was not wasted money after all. Hey, what do you know? It fits perfectly. One down, one to go. In case you were wondering, how am I marking these boards and knowing where to drill the holes? Well, I save the old original boards and I line one up, get it centered pretty well, make a mark and drilled one hole, take it out of the drill press, line up the remains of the old board with that new hole, so it's all flush, and then go to the other end, take drill bit, kind of get it right in the center of the old hole, and make a mark, and that is where I drill. There's also a little bit of give in the leg, so if I'm off a little bit, it will work just fine. Alright, the second board has been drilled and also fits perfectly. Now, before I put this together, I am going to go ahead and sand these boards with 220, hit them with the same provincial stain I used for the top, and then coat them with some poly to stain and seal the wood so it matches the rest. Now, downside to that, of course, it's going to take time. Luckily, I'm not in any real hurry to get this table done, but I think I'll end this video here, and it'll probably be another week before I can proceed to doing final assembly.